Hi everyone, this is Ambroise from Motoplaisir Motorcycle Rental in Geneva. In this video, I'm going to show you the controls of the BMW R1250R 2020. So this is the BMW R1250R. This is a keyless bike. Well, you just keep the fob in your pocket and you switch on the bike here. Okay, let's start on the left side. This button is to flash and you push it forward for high beam. This button is for the cruise control. You switch the cruise control on like this and you can then set the speed. Once the speed is set, you can accelerate or slow down. If you touch anything like clutch, brakes, or you can even push back the throttle like this, it will stop cruising and you can resume the speed pulling the lever here. And you can also switch it off like this. This button is for the LED daylight. So when it is on, you have the little A here. The little A means that when it gets dark or when you go through a tunnel, the bike will automatically switch from the daylight to the main light. This button is for the hazards. Nothing much to say about that. The menu button, you press up to display quite a lot of information. These information are related to the trip meters, trip one or trip two. So you have the brake time, the riding time, the average speed of each of them. You can also display the tire pressure, the range, the fuel gauge, and the kilometers of the bike. You can press the menu button down. So you enter the menu like this, okay. You have my vehicle menu, you press down again. Here you have a display that is about the condition of the bike. So we have one warning that is related to the service, okay. We have the engine temperature, oil level will display once the engine is hot and it's been at idle long enough. When you ride, you have the front and rear tire pressure, battery voltage, the range. Okay, I go to the next page using the wheel like this. So I push the wheel to the right to go to the next page. This is the onboard computer one. If you want to reset some of the informations, you press down, you can reset all the values or only some of them. Okay, you go back to the previous page, you press up the button. I push the wheel to the right to go to the trip computer 2. This one is set to reset automatically every day. Okay, next page is another display about the tire pressure. So you have the specification, 2.5 on the front and 2.9 to the rear. And it will show you the difference and the actual tire pressure. Next page again, we have seen the service is due of a few days. Okay, so we are back to the main menu. If you have the BMW connected app on your phone, you can have a basic navigation here on the display of the bike. Same thing if you have the app on your phone, you can control the music through the bike. Of course, you need a headset in your helmet. Same thing, you can control your phone through the bike, and these are the settings of the bike. Okay, I go back to the first page, pulling on the wheel. Okay, this button is for the ABS and traction control. ABS and traction control are flashing until you ride a few meters. It will stop flashing, that means everything is functioning. You set the suspension with this button. During the ride, you can change the settings of the dampers. You can set them to the dynamic of the road setting, so they will be stiffer on the dynamic setting. Here we can see that the preload is set on auto. That means whatever the weight you put on the bike, if you have a pillion or not, luggage or not, the suspension will adjust itself. So you leave it like this and you're good. Turn signals, right, left, you push to cancel, it also cancels by itself. The horn is under here. On the right here, you have the heated grips with two different settings. You just have to press the button and it shows here. This button is for the riding modes. So it shows here you have the road, dynamic, dynamic pro, and rain. So every time you change the riding mode, it changes the suspension setting, throttle response, ABS, traction control, to make it consistent with the riding mode you're in. Okay, this button is to kill the engine. To start the engine, you press down. No need to accelerate, you just press and hold until the engine starts. To switch off the bike, you just have to press here. To lock the steering, you push the wheelbar to the left, not all the way to the left, and you press and hold this button until you hear it locks. Okay, so now it locks. Fuel cap. So you cannot open the fuel cap if the bike is on. You have to switch off the bike first, and then you are able to open the fuel cap. You can put unleaded 95, 98, or even E10. Let's talk about the cases now. So you have to use the physical key that is with the fob, like this. Everything is written. It's currently open. So you can lift the gray lever to open the lid, like this. Okay. You push the lid back. You close the case like this. You cannot lift the gray lever anymore. If you want to take the case off the bike, you have to turn the key like this, as it's shown here. And then you can lift this black lever. And you should, trying to do that one-handed, and you should grab the handle, otherwise the case can fall down. You put back the case on the bar here and on the mounting point here. So make sure it's on the bar, and then you push back the case. So you lift the black lever and then you can push the case and it locks itself. Okay. To access under the seat, you use the same key. The lock is here. You lift the rear seat. You have a few tools under the seat and a high visibility jacket in case you have to stop on the side of the road. Thank you very much for your attention. This is about it. If you have any questions, you have my mobile phone on the contract. Thanks again for your attention. Enjoy your trip.